A couple of years ago, I upgraded from this $2,500 lens to this $5,500 Cine Prime lens. Was it worth the investment? Is there a real difference in quality? Should you invest in high-priced lenses? In this video, I'll share my experience switching from a photo lens to a Cine Prime lens. Let's jump right in. I'm not paid or endorsed by any brand, nor am I here to push you towards buying anything. I simply wanted to share with you what my experience has been upgrading to a Cine Prime lens. I shoot on a Sony FX6, but I only use Canon lenses. This 24-70 2.8 lens has been a workhorse for me for many, many years. I've used it on just about everything, and I've had no issues with it. But a couple years ago, I wanted to start upgrading the quality of my work and purchased the Canon Cine-E 50mm T1.3. For me, it was an expensive purchase, and I was really hoping to see a big difference between the two lenses. Now, what is a Cine lens? Well, Cine lenses are specifically designed for cinematography rather than photography. What does that mean? Well, the Cine lens has two rings, a focus ring, just like a photo lens, but it also has an aperture ring. The 24-70 lens does not. You can only control the aperture using the settings on the camera. The Cine lens aperture ring is seamless, unlike the stops of the aperture on the 24-70. This means I can go in between stops and really dial in my exposure. The Cine lens come with built-in focus and aperture teeth to use with the follow focus system. Not only can I use a follow focus, but I can also mount a second unit on the aperture ring in case I need to change the exposure while filming. The markings on the Cine lens are very precise, making it much easier when pulling focus to stop exactly where you need to. If you know you need to pull from 2 feet to 4 feet, for example, you can easily see when you reach your mark. On the 24-70, the markings are on top of the lens and are very small. The white numbers, which are in meters, are easier to see than the green numbers, which are in feet. And the reference mark is only on the white side, making it difficult to know precisely where you need to stop when using the green measuring system. And yeah, the sequence is missing a bunch of numbers, so it's hard to tell where 4 feet actually is. Now, why are there green upside down numbers on the Cine lens? Well, those can be used by a focus puller when standing on the right side of the camera. The same goes for the aperture ring. You have white markings on the left side of the lens and green markings on the right side. So you can actually have someone pulling focus on the left side of the camera using the white numbers and someone controlling the aperture on the right side of the lens using the green numbers, for example. The diameter of the housing also plays an important role. The focus ring on the Cine lens is very long, meaning you need to rotate it 300 degrees to go from macro to infinity. The longer the rotation, the more precise control you have over pulling focus. On the 24-70, going from 2 feet to 4 feet is a very quick short turn, about 40 degrees compared to 100 degrees for the Cine lens. The Cine lens has an aperture made of 11 blades compared to the 9 blades of the 24-70. This means the aperture is a lot more round than the octagonal shape of the 24-70 aperture. The result is a more pleasing, smooth bokeh. So are all those little additions really worth the extra money? Well, the real difference is in the quality of the glass itself. The level of polishing and the coating of the glass is what gives every lens its characteristic. There is a big difference in image quality and feel between those two lenses. The other major difference is the speed or the size of the aperture. The 24-70 is an f2.8 lens, so it's fast. But the Cine lens is a T1.3. Now, I understand that you can't directly compare T-stops with F-stops. T-stops measure the amount of light that actually reached the sensor, while F-stops measure the amount of light that enters the lens. But a T1.3 is very fast, and being able to open my aperture that wide allows me to shoot with a very shallow depth of field or in low light situation. From interviews to B-roll, I can always get a beautiful defocus background. One last minor positive about using this lens, and I don't want to sound shallow, but I've had so many amazing comments from clients when setting up my camera. The size and look of this lens really impresses people. And again, who really cares? At the end of the day, the result is what counts. But for sure, it has helped build an image of high quality with my clients, even before they see any of the shots. Now, there are some downsides to working with the Cine Prime. This lens is purely mechanical, so there is no autofocus or controls from the camera. I don't use auto exposure or autofocus, but if you do, this may not be the right lens for you. Using primes also means I have to move the camera to get the framing that I want or swap lenses every time. I can't just zoom in a little. So I need to move the tripod or whatever the rig I'm using. It's also a lot bulkier and heavier, so traveling with multiple of these might be challenging. Now obviously, the price point can also be a challenge. The 24-70 is basically three of these primes. So not only is each lens more expensive, but you need to purchase a full set to match the versatility of the 24-70. Now Canon did release a Cine Zoom series, so you can now get a 45 to 135 millimeter or a 14 to 35, but each of these lenses are around 25K. The truth is, I think I would rather have multiple primes than one zoom lens. Even from a framing perspective, I prefer the natural look of primes versus the compressed look of a zoom. Now, even though the price of the Cine lens have dropped significantly, almost in half in less than 2 years, it's still the best investment I've made. In fact, this lens has been so good that I really shoot everything with it. Now, don't get me wrong, the 24-70 still produces great images, but once you start playing with the Cine lenses, it's hard to go back. Now, the downside is I only have the 50mm for now, and really need to invest in at least two more, the 24 and probably the 85. Good thing those prices have dropped, I guess. Now, thank you for watching this video until the end, and as a token of my appreciation, I'd like to offer you my free camera setting cheat sheet. Just follow the link below to download my free cheat sheet. Thanks again, and happy filming.